Hey everybody, Lee from PC Junkie Mods. So today we're gonna do part three of the video. We're gonna talk about some acrylic bending. I'm gonna go over some of the tools that are actually used. I've seen a lot of questions. How do you do acrylic bending, rigid tubing, whatever you wanna call it. We're not actually gonna be using acrylic. We're gonna be using the PETG, which is pretty close to acrylic, but different properties, a lot more durable. So let's go ahead and talk about some of the tools that I use. The most important tool is your heat gun. So heat guns come in different shapes, different sizes, different heat ranges. This is a pretty good one that I actually got from Harbor Freight for like 30 bucks or something like that. Not too shabby. It has a heat up and then a cold, which is cooled down, which is pretty good. And then you can adjust the heat here. And it also has a little stand. So it screws onto the bottom. There's different angles that you can actually attach it to. Also, what I use, my deburr. Actually just to deburr the end, just get rid of some of the slag per se on the acrylic. I use a black Sharpie to mark where I'm going to be cutting. I use my hacksaw, and then I actually have a miter box also, but everybody probably knows what a miter box is. It's just so I can cut straight. And then another important tool would be your silicone tube. Now, the whole purpose of the silicone tube is to keep the shape of the acrylic. So when you're heating it up, if you heat it up without this, it'll actually deform the roundness. You'll lose the shape. So the whole purpose of the silicone is to keep that shape. And the way I actually get it into the tube is, I have this little bucket over here, soapy water. So I'll wet it down, I'll stick it into the tube. And then once I have it in the position I want it, I go ahead and heat it up, and then once it's done, it starts to cool down, because once I get my bend, what I'll do is I'll hold it when it's hot. Once it cools down a little bit, I'll actually pull that tube out and then make sure I keep that that 90 or whatever it is the bend I'm doing. I also have a nice long piece just in case I'm doing multiple bends. And then I have a towel to clean up my soapy water that I get everywhere. But I mean, for the most part, that pretty much covers my tools. So let's go ahead and look at the desk, and I'll show you what I've already done and kind of the layout of the way the desk is going to be. So here we are at the desk. So what I've done is a couple things that are different. I mean, pretty much like this I still haven't screwed in, so it's just kind of still sitting there. I'll talk about some fan grills, what I've done with the fan grills, but let's talk about what's going on in here first. So I went ahead and got the Titan Blacks. They're water cooled now. They have the water blocks on. I'm using the GTX 780 Ti water blocks from EK. They do fit on the Titans, so I'm using those and the back plate, and then I have the bridge here. Also, another cool thing that I've done is I've actually wired in one of the LED plugs, so that way I get the LED power. I'm able to use the GeForce Experience, because this is going to run over to my GeForce logo that I have over here. So I'll be able to tune the lighting, turn it up, make it brighter, or turn it down, or make it flash, or whatever. And the SLI bridge will do the same thing, because it is GeForce Experience capable of control. So as far as the water cooling goes, everything's just kind of sitting in here. When these, I had these screwed in, and when I had them screwed in, I went ahead and laid out my fill port and drain port. So this is to be a double valve, one for each side. So this valve would be for these two reservoirs, and this valve would be for this reservoir, and so on and so forth for the fill port. So basically what I can do is I can drain out this system just by cracking that open and popping the cap down there without actually affecting my other side. I figured this is the most simplest way to be able to fill and drain both systems. So I'm hoping that, I know I'm gonna have to tilt my desk up in order to get this pretty much topped off, which is gonna be a little complicated because unfortunately on these reservoirs, I wish the center hole was actually off center to the top, because if it was toward the top, it'd make life a lot easier. So I'll probably talk to Brian about that at Primo Chill and see if possibly he can off center for future revisions. This is a prototype. This isn't quite out yet. That is a shotgun res. I'm really looking forward to using it. It's going to have a bunch of liquid dual pump, single loop. So for the most part, you see the fill in the drain. What I have here is this will be the first tube we're going to bend. This is the Aqua Computer fan controller. I have the water block on it. So this tube is going to run straight across and tie right into the top of this reservoir right here. So that'll be that. And then it's going to exit to the flow meters. This one is most likely going to come out and elbow into the wall here, which will feed over to the CPU blocks, I think. Can't remember what the flow was. I don't know. There's so many different configurations that I've totally like drawn a blank right now. But I think it's going to come out and go directly to the CPU block, and then out of the CPU block into the radiator, out of the 360 into the video cards, and then out of the video cards into the 480, which will come back and tie into that over there, which is going to come through the bottom here. It's going to run straight across. Underneath there will be another 3 power adjust sitting here on the back, so it'll run right under that and then tie into this fitting, which returns back into the reservoir. So that, I mean, pretty much that's the idea in theory. Hopefully that's going to work out, but we'll see. So, and then as far as the other setup goes, most likely I'm gonna have to drill 2 holes here because I like the clean look of coming straight back into the wall. So I'm gonna drill 2 holes for those guys. Those are both of those tubes will come straight in and come back here. The in and the out, I think I'm just gonna come, this will be the return. So I'm gonna come straight across the flow meter and plug into the wall, and this guy will plug into here, and then everything will be done back here. So basically it's gonna come out of here, go directly into the CPU, and then from the CPU into the radiator, and then the radiator will be the return. Pretty simple, keep it easy. So let's go ahead and start bending. All right, so we got all the tubes bent, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you that, and we're gonna go ahead and install them. I have some of them laid out here right now. As you can see, most of the system's all laid out. I did go ahead and lock this one in before we fired up the camera because it is the hardest to get to, and it's just awkward. So I didn't wanna struggle with it on camera. then I'm gonna lock all these guys in, and then we're gonna actually fill the loop up today. So let's go ahead and lock these down, and we'll be right back. We'll be right back. All right, so that's the last fitting. So all the tubes are tied in nice and tight. So let's go ahead and move over to the side over here because there's an upgrade that I've gotten recently. So I need to show you about that. So I went ahead and replaced out the board and the RAM. I went to a Z97 Asus Asus Z97 Plus. And then I got some more Dominator Platinums. I bought the 8 gig kit because I only had a 4 gig kit on here. I thought it was 8, but it's not. So this is still going to be the server side over here, but I figured at this point, you know, I got a good deal on the board and the RAM, so I went ahead and picked those up. And I'm going to take the other board and CPU and put it in my media center in the living room. So another thing I wanted to talk about is the fan grill. So this is the fan grill here, and I didn't have any kind of mesh or dust filter or whatever you want to call it. So what I have here is my wife's leotard. So this is just a cheap fix if you got a girlfriend or a wife. Basically, all the fan grills already have them installed. So I'm gonna take this one, I'm gonna actually show you how I installed it. And then what I'll do is once I punch all the screws through it and attach the fans to it, I will take a razor and I'll come around and trim off the top piece and cut off the edge. And then all you'll see is fan grill, and behind it, it'll still have the mesh or the leotard at that point. So we got both sides filled. We had a couple issues. Had a radiator here in the back. Turns out it had a hole in it. Pretty big hole. Almost looks like a screwdriver stabbed into it or something. So needless to say, 50% of the liquid that I put into the server side dumped into the back here. Me and Dwight scrambled around and got it cleaned up the best we could and fixed the problem. That's why I have now a shiny rad back here instead of the flat black rad that was there. This pretty much wraps up this video. Both systems are full. So in the next video, I'm hoping to do some wiring and the LEDs or the RGB kit that I got from BS Mods. That's my buddy Bob. So if you get a chance, go check him out. He's got some really good prices on RGB kits. That's bsmods.com. I'm hoping to have the system fully up and running in the next video. So we'll see how that goes. I'd also like to give a shout out to Hank from Performance PCs. Performance PCs, this is where I get all my mod stuff and all my fittings, water blocks, you name it. This is a guy to go see. Thanks again. Until next time.